Today, we're going to talk about font licensing. Now, I know this is a topic that can be a little bit confusing. So if you want to purchase a font to upload to Shopify so that you can customize your website, I'm going to walk you through in Creative Market, which is the font license that is best for you. And maybe you need two licenses. So let's jump into Creative Market and let me show you the difference between the two. So here we are in Creative Market. And here is the font licenses and how you can use them, okay? So for most of my audience, the two licenses that you're going to need is either your desktop license or your web font license or both, okay? So the desktop license is for unlimited commercial and personal projects, including but not limited to physical and products. So for my print on demand people, this is the license that you need. And then social media packaging and paid ads. Okay, so if you're creating these things, you can use the desktop license. Also, you can use the desktop license to upload to Canva, and you're gonna use the Canva to create your social media and your paid ads, okay? So this is the desktop license. That's what you will need, one desktop license for one desktop, okay? And then the web font license is the license that you're going to need to add this font or any font to a website. This font is so pretty. I can't wait to use it. But here is the font, and these are the licenses that are available for this particular font, okay? Now, not all licenses are available for all fonts, so just know that. For the web font, when you click here, it says starting at $19, right? And the reason for that is because the web font license is based on your page view. So if you're just starting out, you can purchase the 10K a month license. And as your business grows and you start to get more page views, then you can come back and purchase the next tier license. Okay. Now note that, let's say, for example, let's come back to this awesome font here. This particular font does not have a web font license, which means you cannot use this font on a website. Okay, so you have to be really careful when you're purchasing fonts, that you're purchasing the correct font license and that you're using it for the purpose in which that license was intended. There's a lot of websites that have free fonts. Just make sure that you check the description and see how you could use that font, okay? Don't assume that if it says commercial use, that you could use that font however you see fit, because that's not the case, okay? So we'll come back over here. You'll see that there's other licenses. So based on how you want to use that font, if you want to also use that font in an app, then you have to purchase an app license. And if you want to do an EPUB, you can also purchase the license for that as well. My name is Betsy from Betsy Dugo Creative. I hope that this video helped you understand font licensing just a little bit better so that you can purchase the license that's best for you. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Until next time, my friends, adios.